I was brought up on Cousteau's voyages by my father when I was much younger, who was a diver himself, and he'd kind of told me these incredible stories of diving at reefs around the world. I work in the Chagos Archipelago Marine Protected Area. This is an extraordinarily remote coral reef. In fact, one of the most remote coral reef systems in the world. And one of the reasons this is so interesting is because it's a system where we can study the effects of climate change without the confounding factors of human impacts. Corals are wonderful ancient denizens of the sea. They have representatives from essentially every single kingdom, kind of nestled within a single kind of coral colony, and you've got the microbes, the viruses, the bacteria, the archaea, fungi, protists. You have the fish and the shrimp, and each one of these brings its own little microbial party to the coral and share these various organisms. So it's an extraordinarily difficult system to work with. By using molecular tools, we can actually examine the DNA of these particular organisms and actually tease apart these kind of very complex communities. I've been using QIAGEN kits now for a decade or more, and they have been the market leaders in a lot of the DNA extraction kits that we work with. Molecular techniques are particularly important when it comes to looking at the factors that affect corals. Things like climate change factors, things like direct human impacts. If we see certain genes that are related to stress, or a confounding of the immune system, or even a proliferation of a particular pathogen which is going to cause a problem, then these are things that we can essentially see well in advance of symptoms of coral stress. And that means we might actually be able to manage and mitigate these factors given time.
QIAGEN.
Sample to insight.